Good morning, students. Now I am going to explain static force analysis of a given mechanisms. The given mechanism is slider crank mechanisms. So the problem is, in the slider crank mechanism shown in figure, the value of force applied to slider 4 is 2 kN. The dimension of various links are AB is equal to 80 mm, BC is equal to 240 mm, then theta is equal to 60 degrees. Determine the forces on various links and driving torque. So our requirement is to find out the forces on the various links and driving torque T2. So to maintain the equilibrium of these mechanisms, our main aim is the given mechanism has two equilibriums. For maintaining the equilibriums, what are the forces is acting on your various links and torque. Okay, so this is the given diagrams. Already you know this very well. You know this is the slider crank mechanism. So this is the crank, this connecting rod and pistons, and cylinder is the fixed link. The link one is the cylinder, is act as a fixed link. The crank link two is crank, the link 3 is the connecting rod, link 4 is piston. So on the piston, there is 2 kN forces acting horizontally. So this is the given problem. Okay. Now I am going to explain step by step. So first step, given data. So force applied to the cylinder is 2 kN, right? Dimension of the links of the mechanism, that is AB. AB is equal to 80 mm. BC is equal to 240 mm. Then theta, this theta angle, that is the crank making with the horizontal, the crank angle making with the horizontal is 60 degrees. So these data are given. This is the first step. Then second step, state the requirements. So what is the need? First question is, find the forces on various links. So we have to find the forces on various links. Then second is, find the driving torque T2. That is the, this is the one of the torque we need, T2, that magnitude and directions. Step number 3 is, draw the configuration diagram of given mechanism to a suitable sketch. So, draw a configuration diagram with suitable scale. Suitable scales. I am taking scale is 1:2 because I am drawing this diagram in A4C. So I am taking the scale value is 1:2. 1:2 means if the actual dimension is 100 mm, we have to draw the 50 mm length. That is the 1:2. But on the link you write the original dimensions. First, okay. First you draw a horizontal axis. On the horizontal axis you make a point A. This is point A. Then this inclination is 60 degrees. From the horizontal axis, you take 60 degrees. You take 60 degrees, and now you join, draw a line A to B. The length is 80 mm. The length is 80 mm. For our scale is 1:2. Here actually this is 40 mm because our scale is 1:2. So actual dimension is A to B is 40 mm. After drawing the line A to B, you write the 80 mm. You write the 80 mm. The dimension is 80 mm. Now you got point B. From point B, you draw another line to C. So this is BC. The length is 240 mm. Actual original length is 240 mm. But you draw the B. You take B to C length is 120 because our scale is 1:2. Okay. Now we have point A, point B, point C. Then one more link is, that is piston. You take any dimensions for piston. This is the piston. Okay. On the piston there is a 2 kN horizontal force is acting. That's all. This is the configuration diagram. Okay. Now go to the step number 4. Step number 4, draw free body diagram of the links. free body diagram of each lens. What is free body diagram? Free body diagram means this is an isolated diagram. This is an isolated diagram. So we have to draw the link isolated from original diagrams and mark the each what are the forces acting on the link only. There is no need actual dimensions, but line of action is important. Line of action is important. Line of force is important. So this is link 2. This is link 2. This point is A, this is point B. The link 2, on the link 2, there is torque T2 is acting, then force F32 is acting on point B and force F12 is acting on point A. F12 means force is acting from link 1 to link 2. Here, F32 means force acting from point 3 to link 2. So this is meaning for F32. So this is the free body diagram of link 2. Now you draw free body diagram of link 3. This is the link 3. You need not fix the actual dimensions, but to draw a parallel to this original configuration diagrams. You need not fix the original dimensions. Just you draw parallel lines. That's all. Then mention the what are the forces acting on the particular link. So in this three link 3 at point B force 2 3 is acting and point C force 4 3 is acting. 2 3 means force is acting from link 2 to 3. Here F 4 3 means force is acting from link 4 to 3. So this is the free body diagram of link 3. That's all. The next link is piston. So this is the piston. So what are the forces acting here? The horizontal force 2 kN is acting, then force 3 4 is acting, then reaction force 1 4 is acting. 1 4 is acting, reaction force. This is the free body diagram of link 4. Once again I am telling, so what is free body diagram? It's isolated from the original diagrams, so, but what are the forces acting on the link? So this is the free body diagrams. Okay. Now this is link 2, this is link 3, this is link 4. I am going to next step. Next step, draw the force polygon for the link 4 and apply suitable scale for the given force. Here apply suitable scale for given force. So step 5 is draw the force polygon for the link 4. Why we are taking link 4? Link 4 only we have known value, force known value. That is 2 kN force known value is only available on link 4. That's why we are selecting the link 4 to draw the force polygon. Okay. Here 3 forces are acting. So known force is 2 kN is acting from right to left. Okay. Now you put your point O. Put your point O. So known force is 2 kN horizontal wise from right to left. Okay. For 2 kN, first you fix the scale. Directly we cannot draw the 2 kN on drawing sheet. So for this 2 kN, to draw 2 kN, first you fix the scale. So I am fixing the scale. 1 mm is equal to 40 Newton. 1 mm equal to 40 Newton. Okay. From the point, first you then you make the point O. From point O, for this 2 kN, I am going to draw the line O to A. O to A. So, what is this length O to A? Right. Our scale is for 40 Newton is 1 mm. For 40 Newton is 1 mm. Then for 200 Newton is 50 mm. 40 Newton is 1 mm into 200 Newton is 50 mm. So the length is 50 mm. Okay. I am converting 2 kN force in terms of the in terms of millimeter. That is 50 mm. So O to A is 50 mm. The direction is parallel to this line, this force, parallel to this force. Okay. So O to A is horizontal force. This acting on the piston. The right. Next, This is the reaction force, F14. Always reaction force is always perpendicular to the applied force. Okay. F34 is acting downwards. So F14 is acting, the vertical component F14 is acting upwards. So definitely it will acting upwards. So from point A, that's why I am drawing point from point A, vertically draw a line, another line. That is F14. Here we have only direction, no magnitude. So just you draw a vertical line. Okay. Leave as it is. Then go to the next force. What is our next force? F34. Okay. Now you draw the parallel to this line. From point O. You draw a parallel to this force. This line. From point O you draw this. So this line and this line intersecting at point B. This line and this line will intersecting at point B. Now AB is the vertical force. AB is your reaction force F14. Then BO is force acting on link 3. Right. After draw this force diagrams. We have to calculate what amount of force is acting on each the given link. Okay. By measurement from drawn force polygon, that AB dimension is 15 mm. Now you convert this length into force. For F14, 15 mm length. So multiplied with our scale factor. Our scale factor is 40. 1 mm is equal to 40 newton. So 15 into 40, that is 600 newton. F14 is 600 newton. Same way, that is BO. BO is F34. That is force acting on link 3, B4. The length BO is 53 mm. Our scale factor is 40. So 53 into 40, 2120 newton. So this much of force is acting on link 3. Okay. Now going to next step. So from this step, we are calculating force acting on link 3 and reaction force of F14. That's all. Now going to next step 3. Step 6. Draw the link 2 and apply the suitable forces to calculate couple and driving torque T2 and identify the direction of driving torque and couples. Okay. For this, you draw the free body diagram of link 2. So this is the link 2. Here we have to draw the original length. That is, this is free body diagram. Free body diagram of link 2, but the length is 80 mm. Here I am taking scale 1:1. Suppose if you draw scale is 1:2, you measure this distance and multiply it with your scale factor. But here I have taken scale is 1:1. So the length is 80 mm. The length of link 2 is 80 mm. But the inclination with horizontal is 60 degree. From the configuration diagram, straight away I am taking this link 2. Okay. Link 2, there are two points. That is A and B. Point B, the force F32 is acting. What is meaning for 32? Force is acting from link 3 on link 2. Here F12, force is acting from link 1 on link 2. So this is F12. Okay. F32 is known value. From the force polygon, we have taken F32 value. That is 2120. From the previous step, we have taken 2120. Right. If here F32 and F12 will make a couple, that is the anti-clockwise couple. This force will acting in this direction. Automatically, here anti-clockwise couple will be created. So what is the magnitude of this couple? So F32 into perpendicular distance between the two forces. So F32 value is 2120. this value we have taken from the previous steps, okay, into h, that is the perpendicular height from this force to this force. This line of action, this is the line of action of F32, this is the line of action of F12. We have to take this vertical height, that is perpendicular to this line. This is 79 mm. First you draw this link to, then apply the force F32 and F12, then you take the this height, this is 79 mm. So what is coupled? Force into perpendicular distance, this is force value 2120 into height, that is 79 mm. If you multiply both, you can get 167559 newton mm, but this is anti-clockwise direction. Okay, in newton meter, that is 167.559 newton meter, counterclockwise direction. This is the couple. Okay, if the couple is acting anti-clockwise direction, this is applied torque will act clockwise direction, then only the link will maintain the equilibrium. So torque on the link is same value but in opposite direction. Okay, so torque is same value in clockwise directions. That's all. So this is the problem under static force analysis of a slider crank mechanism. In the next class, we will see the static force acting on the four bar mechanism. Thank you.